Yes, hi guys, let me continue. Now, question number 13. So, question number 13 is okay, show that first A part and then B part. There are two parts of this. Let me take them one by one. Okay, so question 13, number 13. Now, let me take show that it says do show that A part. What is the A part? That cos of square of theta minus pi upon 2 angle here minus sine square theta plus phi, this is theta plus phi upon 2, theta plus phi upon 2 is equal to cos theta into cos phi, yeah, into cos phi. This we have to prove here. Question number 13. To show that cos square theta minus phi upon 2 minus sine square theta plus phi upon 2. Okay, this is equal to cos theta into cos phi. Here theta and phi, there are two angles, and in terms of like A and B. Okay, so we could write it as A minus B upon 2 sine square theta. A plus B upon 2, like that, the same similar quantity. First let me do A part of this. This is solution we are finding out. And let me take first left hand side. Here left hand side is cos square of theta minus phi upon 2 minus sine of square theta plus phi upon 2. Okay, now we know that. What we know, this we have proved, okay, in the previous lecture series, that cos square A minus sine square B, something like this, okay, sine square B, if it is sine square B, is equal to cos of A plus B into cos of A minus B. So this we have proved, cos square A minus sine square B is equal to cos A plus B into cos A minus B. So similarly, this is cos square A minus sine square B is equal to this value cos A plus B cos A minus B. Therefore, cos of square theta minus phi upon 2. In place of A, we have this minus sine square theta plus phi upon 2 is equal to cos of this plus this. That means theta minus phi upon 2 plus theta plus phi upon 2 upon, okay, nothing. Only this is A plus B. Only this is A plus B. Into cos A minus B, that means theta minus phi upon minus sine theta plus phi upon 2, like this. Let me take this as curly bracket here. Okay, so let me solve it now. If I take 2 as the LCM, 2 LCM here, so we get in the first bracket of this cos of. I mean the first bracket of this is theta minus phi plus theta plus phi upon 2 LCM. Phi plus and minus phi cancel out into cos. This is theta minus phi minus theta minus phi. So this minus sign, if I open, then minus theta and minus phi will become upon 2 LCM. Here we see that theta minus theta plus theta cancel out, and this is cos 2 theta upon 2, cos 2 theta upon 2 into cos minus 2 phi upon 2 into cancel out, which is nothing but cos of theta into cos of minus phi. But we know that since cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta positive, because it is an even function, not odd function. If it is odd function, if it could be odd function, then it could be negative. But in this case, cos secant are even functions, because sine, cosec, tan, cot are odd functions. They angle, if it is negative of theirs, then they become negative. But in this case, cos will become positive. This is cos minus phi. We can write it as cos theta into cos of phi. This is the right hand side. This is the right hand side here. Simple application of cos square a minus sin square b, cos a plus b, cos a minus b. Substitute these two some formulae. Now here we are solving the questions based on sum and difference formulae of trigonometric functions. Sum and difference formulae of trigonometric functions. We are doing questions based upon them. If there is okay, and this is sum and difference formulae of cos a plus b, cos a minus b. We have okay, group this was equal to cos square a minus sin square b. Okay, so that formula we have used here in the same answer is obtained. So this is the right answer, hence answer. But let me get next question. Now question number 14. This is 13 question. Question take 14. Question number 14. What does it say? Now question number 14 is, let me check it. Okay, so question number 14 says, sorry, B part is still is there. 13th B part. I'm sorry, it is 13th B part, I just forgot about. 13th B part again. So 13th B part is to show that cos square A plus cos square B minus 2 cos of A into cos of B into cos of A plus B, right, into cos of A plus B is equal to, we have to prove, is equal to sine square cos A plus B. Okay, sorry, this is second part of question number 13. Cos square A plus cos square B minus 2 cos A cos B cos A plus B. Cos A plus B, so there are three cos here, cos A, cos B, and cos of A plus B equal to sin square A plus B. We have to do. Okay, so let's take left hand side of this. Left hand side, which is equal to cos square A plus cos square B minus 2 cos of A into cos of B into cos of A plus B. Okay, we have to do this. So we can write this cos square B as plus, this is 1 minus sin square B. No change, but cos square theta, since cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sin square theta, the very first fundamental identity of trigonometry. Sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. From there, cos square theta equal to 1 minus sin square theta. So we have substituted here in place of cos square b at 1 minus sin square b. Minus 2 cos of a into cos of b into cos of a plus b. Now we cos square a minus sin square b, let me put here, cos square a minus sin square b is minus sin square b plus 1. This one. Minus 2, same value, cos A cos B into cos of A plus B. This we have used here. So, this cos square A minus sin square B, as we used in the first part of this formula, is equal to cos A plus B into cos A minus B. And this is plus 1, as it is minus 2. Cos of A, cos of B, into cos of A plus B. But we see a cos A plus B, cos A plus B. If I take common out of this and this, we will get here cos of A plus B, that will take common. we obtain here cos A minus B. This is cos A minus B minus 2 cos A cos B. This value is obtained. This plus 1 as it is. This plus 1 we have separated. So cos A minus B, if I open, let me open that. This is cos A plus B. Out of the bracket. Cos A plus B. Okay, into cos A minus B, if I open, it should be cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. Why? Because this is minus sign. In case of cos A minus B, it becomes plus. If it is cos A plus B, then it will become negative. But in this case, it is negative. Both the terms are positive. Since cos A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So this formula we have used here. Sin A sin B, sorry. This is sin A sin B. So this cos A plus cos A cos B plus sin A sin B in place of cos A minus B. We have substituted minus 2 cos A cos B plus 1. This one. What we see here, this is 2 minus 2 cos A cos B. This is cos A cos B, so 1 negative will remain. It is nothing but cos of A plus B. Yeah. Into, if I take sign. Okay, let me take this negative sign. If I take common out of this negative, because this is twice and this is single, so negative value will remain. Minus cos A cos B will become positive. Now if I take negative sign common, it will be now cos A cos B minus sin sin A sin B into sin A sin B plus sin this 1. Let me write here this plus 1. Okay, so this plus 1 is there. What we see here, cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, this is nothing but cos A plus B. Type on this. This is cos A plus B. With the minus sign is there, so this minus sign we have taken, because it is multiplied to this. It will become minus cos A plus B into cos A plus B. Why? The same formula we have. If we open here, cos A minus B in place of cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, we have substituted here cos A plus B. Here it was A minus B, so it was plus sign, but in this case it is a minus sign. In between, so it will become cos A plus B. So cos A plus B into cos A plus B plus 1. We have obtained here 1 minus, so this is cos A plus B into cos A plus B, that means cos square of A plus B. Now this is 1 minus cos square theta type. This is equal to sin square. The whole value will be equal to sin square A plus B. For we know that this 1 minus cos square theta equal to sin square theta, because cos square theta equal to 1 minus sin square theta. Now first sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. This 1 minus cos square A plus B equal to sin square A plus B. This is the right hand side. This is the right hand side here. So hence put, this is the question which is based on cos square A minus sin square B equal to cos A plus B into cos A minus. This question was based on, 13th question was based on this basic formula. Now let me take the next 14th question now. For 13th part having two parts, both the parts now here solved. So now let me take 14th. Question number 14 is of what kind? Let me check. Okay. So question number 14. It says something else. What is that? 10? It is question 14. If 10 beta is equal to this, okay, it is given to us. If 10 of beta is given to us, what is the value of this? N into sin alpha into cos alpha divided by, this is 1 minus n into sine square alpha. This is W of 10 beta. Okay. Then we prove that. What we do? We prove that. With that, then A alpha minus beta. We have to prove that 10 alpha minus beta is equal to. Okay, this is 1 minus n into n alpha. Is it 10 alpha? Yeah. It is 10 alpha. You prove that 10 alpha minus beta is equal to 1 minus n is equal to 1 minus n into 10 alpha. This is 10 alpha beta. It means we have to open 10 alpha minus beta. And that we will substitute value 10 beta. Okay, then after that we will solve it. And we reach up, try to reach up to 1 minus n into 10 alpha. That is the right hand side. Now let me take left hand side of this. Sorry, we have to do this. The solution. Left hand side. Whatever we have to do, this to. This is given to us. This is given. 10 beta equal to this. Okay. The left hand side is 10 alpha minus beta. Okay, just we open what is 10 A minus B formula is 10 alpha minus 10 beta divided by 1 plus 10 alpha into 10 beta. Since 10 A minus B is equal to 10 A minus 10 upon 1 minus, that is 1 plus 10 A into 10. This is given to us by this. We have to use here this formula. This we have used. Now substituting the value of n b. So let me write here substituting the value of 10 beta given. What is given to us? That value we have to put here. So this is equal to 10 alpha as it is. Let me put minus 10 beta. 10 beta is this. This is n into sine alpha cos alpha divided by 1 minus n into sine square alpha. Okay. Whole divided by this is over sine of this division. 1 plus 10 alpha into 10 beta. 10 beta is n into sine alpha cos alpha divided by 1 minus n into sine square alpha. Okay, taking LCM and solving it. LCM is 1 minus n sine square alpha. Okay, let me take that. So, taking LCM, 1 minus 10 alpha in the numerator. So we have taken here 1 minus n into sine square alpha LCM. We have to multiply by 10 alpha to this 1 minus n sine 10 alpha as it is, because 1 into 10 alpha minus sine n into 10 alpha into sine square alpha minus sine n into as it is, because n sine alpha into cos alpha as it is value with negative sign divided by rho sine of division. Again same LCM, this is 1 minus n into sine square alpha LCM, and the remaining value will be this 1 into this whole, that means 1 minus n into sine square alpha plus 10 alpha n into 10 alpha, sorry, n into 10 alpha into sine alpha into cos alpha. This 1 minus n sine square alpha, 1 minus sine n into 1 minus n into sine square alpha, which was the LCM, is cancelled. Okay, so let me now do this here. In the beginning, excluding the whole value. Here, this we have obtained tan alpha minus tan inverse. Now, tan alpha is nothing but sine alpha of cos alpha into sine square alpha that we have taken minus tan into sine alpha into cos alpha is 4 divided by this value. This is 1 minus n into sine square alpha plus n into this is sine alpha upon cos alpha because tan alpha means into sine alpha into cos alpha. Now this cos alpha, let's think out. Okay. No problem. So this is 1 minus plus n into sin square alpha and plus sin square alpha and this value cancelled out. This is n into sin square alpha now. This is minus n sin square alpha. These both are cancelled out. Only one is left over there. Now let me further solve it. If we are opened with, if we are left with n alpha minus n into. Okay. Now if I take cos alpha LCM, I'll take. But before that, we have to reach up to 1 minus 10, 1 minus n into 10. It is nothing but 1 minus n into tan alpha into sine x alpha. Still, let me put the same thing. Tan alpha into sine x alpha minus n into sine alpha into cos alpha. Okay. This is the value here. Is plus sine minus, okay, and divide by 1, this 1 is left, so nothing left, because this whole value is cancelled out. Divide by 2, this is the only value which is left with us. Now, let me think about this. This is sine alpha. Sine alpha, if I take common, and the value is 1 minus 10 alpha. Anything mistaken? Okay. Now it can be 10 alpha, 10 alpha. Okay, let me take common. So it will be 10 alpha if I have taken common out of these two. It will give us 1 minus n into sine square alpha. The same value. Yeah, 1 minus n 10 into minus n into 10 sin alpha minus n into sin alpha into cos alpha. Is it the same value? Yes, yeah, sin alpha cos alpha. Alright. This is 10 beta. This one. Also put here. Now, do you know what this cancel out? So, this is the value here minus n sin alpha into cos alpha. Okay, now if I take sin alpha upon cos alpha as the value, let me put change the sin 10 alpha as sin alpha upon cos alpha and then take cos alpha LCM, that will give us something 1 minus sin square alpha and this is minus n into sin alpha into cos alpha divided by 1. Let me take LCM as cos alpha LCM. Cos alpha is the LCM. Here we are left with sin alpha into 1 minus, I am not multiplying this yet. And this is your sin square alpha, as it is minus n, this will be sin alpha into cos square alpha. Why? Because this cos alpha into cos alpha, cos square alpha. This is the value. Now let me further solve it. Hier. So. Now we are given here. We are left with sin alpha. This is in bracket. It is 1 minus. We have to multiply this into the bracket. This is sin alpha into 1. That means sin alpha minus n into sin q alpha. So sin alpha into n sin square alpha. That is n sin q alpha. Minus sin n into sin alpha into cos square alpha. Whole divided by cos alpha. Well, see. Okay, now let me check something common. Now, out of these two terms, sin alpha is common. Let me take n sin alpha common, which is sin alpha minus n into sin alpha common. N into sin alpha common. What is the leftover value? This is sin square alpha. Now, minus minus plus. The minus sign we have taken common. This plus cos square alpha here left over. This whole divided by cos alpha. This is 1 because sin square, since sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. It is nothing but sin alpha minus n into sin alpha into 1 divided by cos alpha. Now let me take sin alpha 1. So this is 1 minus n only left over upon cos alpha. Now sin alpha upon cos alpha is 10 alpha. It is nothing but 1 minus n into 10 alpha. For sin alpha upon cos alpha is 10 alpha. 10 alpha into 1 minus n. Or 1 minus n into 10 alpha. This is the same right hand side. This is equal to right hand side we have taken. Hence, this is question number 14. We have that. Question number 14 is completed now. Okay, now let me take next question. Question number 15 up. What does question number 15 say? Let me check. Okay, these questions are based on sum and difference formula for trigonometric functions. Trigonometric functions. The sum and the difference formula that we discussed in the beginning in the lecture series 5. Now in 6th lecture series, I've taken question based on that. So that the topic is clear. Okay. Now, 15th question number 15. What is that? It says, if 10 alpha or A, is it 10A or 10? 10A, sorry. It is 10a plus sin a is equal to n. M algebraical value, scalar value i, comma. So 10a plus sin a equal to m and 10a and 10a minus sin a is equal to n. Okay. Let us take is equal to n, 10 a minus sin a equal to n, then to show that what we have to show here, then to show that n square minus n square is equal to 4 into under root of m into n. This we have to prove here. Obviously, what is given to us? N square minus n square. Right? So, what are the values of m and n? They are given to us. We will just multiply them. Okay. So, this is 4 and into n. Let me take left hand side here. Here, solution. Solution is left hand side. If m square minus n square given to us, this is, we have to prove that m square minus n square equal to this, where m and n are given values. Okay, so this we have to prove. So m square minus n square we have taken. Since a square minus b square equal to a plus b in one bracket, another bracket, a minus b. Okay, so we can write it as
n plus n into n minus n. You can write, you know, what the value of m and n, if you substitute them, this is in one bracket it is tan a plus tan b, sorry, sin a, tan a plus sin a, plus sin n, n is that tan a minus sin a, in one bracket this is m plus n, in another bracket m minus n, m is tan a plus sin a minus sin tan a and minus minus plus, because this is minus sin a, it will become plus sin a. Now this is m minus n, this is m plus n. So this m, m square minus n square is m plus n, m minus n. Since this we know what. Okay, from algebra, a square minus b square equal to a plus b into a minus b. In the same way we have substituted here, m square minus n square is m plus n into m minus n. Now put the value of m and n, m plus n, this is m plus n, m minus n. And minus n will make this positive, minus sign a will become positive. Plus sin a. What we see here? Minus sin a plus sin a cancelled out. Minus tan a plus tan a cancelled out. We are left with 2 tan a in the first bracket. Second bracket, 2 sin a into 2 sin a. This is nothing but 4 tan a into sin a. Tan A into sin A. This is 4 tan A sin A. This is value. Now, m into n, if I multiply these two values, then let me solve them. What are those values? M into n will be multiplication of these two. Now, since m into n is equal to, let me put the value of n. Tan A plus sin A into tan A minus sin A, sorry, this is minus sin A, tan A minus sin A, tan A plus sin A. These two values are given to us. This is value of n. Value of n we have multiplied. Since m into n is equal to this, let me multiply them. This is A plus B and A minus B is between them. Tan squared A minus sin squared A